Okay, welcome everyone to the Data Pool introduction tutorial. Before we actually jump into some of these examples, we're going to just briefly go through what our overview is going to be here. And first of all, what we want to know is, what is Data Pool? And Data Pool, we can really think of are relational plugins that will affect other containers within the scene when you enter some data. Also, if it helps, you can think of Data Pool as a reception area where it receives data. So really, any external software can address it without knowing any container names or hierarchy in the scene tree. Why would you want to use a data pool? And like we just mentioned, really, you can use it to send external data or to receive external data without really knowing anything about the scene, any container names or things like that. Really, what you'll need to know is just some text variables to be able to send the data to the right container. Before we jump in though, we'll also just want to briefly touch on another element that we're going to be using here, which is called Viz Send. Since we did not actually write our external software here to connect to Viz, what we're going to do is use something that comes with Vizrt. And there's a Viz Send module that we can use to actually send data to Viz Artist. So we'll briefly touch on that and do that in a couple examples as well. And finally, then we'll actually do some data pool examples, and these aren't going to be too advanced. They're just going to be pretty much an introduction to the theory of data pool to get you started. So without further ado, I guess we can jump in and get started. So let's go ahead and let's open up a brand new scene, or you can just create a brand new scene. I have a scene created here that I'm just going to double click to open. First of all, if you did not have your data pool plugins installed, you should, if you're following along, have them installed. If not, it's not a big deal. You can go back and install them later. But if you do have your data pool plugins installed, you'll find them in the built-ins folder in the container plugins, and you'll find them in the data folder here. So if you click in your data folder, you'll have a bunch of blue plugins here. These all represent the data pool plugins. Also, besides these plugins within the container plugins, if we jump over to the scene plugins, we'll also have a couple of other data pool plugins that we'll also be using. And these are really scene plugins, which we need to drop into our scene settings. So the first thing that we want to do here is really quite simple. And what we're going to do is just use some text to see how this works. So very first thing I need to do when it comes to data pool is go into my scene settings, and you'll see this little area. If we click in here, we have a plugin area. There's a area or center area here that we can drag our data pool plugin. So what we'll want to do is go into our scene plugins, the data folder, and take our data pool plugin here and drag it into this center column. And you can see this little area in the upper right. This is really the reception area where we're going to be receiving data or typing in data to affect our scene. Let's go over into our server. You can find a font if you want. So we'll drag a font down, and we'll just leave the name as is. Let's go into our built-ins, into our container plugins, find the data folder. And what we're going to do first is just take this data text. It says text blah blah right here. So you can just take this and drag this onto our text field. So I'm going to go ahead and click on my text. So I'm going to go ahead and click on my data text here. And first thing that we want to do here is change the field name, so I can give this anything I want. So if I just want to type in text right there, that's fine. Now, to show you how this works, very simply, what we're going to do is jump into our scene settings and come into our data pool plugin here. And what we need to do is just type in text equals, and we can type anything that we want. Notice that when I hit text equals, it goes away. So we can now type in something like data pool. Now, we typed it in this reception area, and we did not type it in the text editor, but the text editor did populate with whatever we typed in within the scene settings here. So very simple. That is data pool in its simplest form. Now, we would have an external program that actually send this command or this text information into this reception area here to receive that data.